Just like any other living creature, a bee needs food as an energy source and a material to build its body. I mentioned in the previous video that nectar is the major food source of honeybees, but they also use protein-rich pollen in their diet, especially to feed baby bees. The classic story of a bee gathering food goes like this. A forager bee leaves the hive actively seeking for flowers that can provide nectar and pollen. Upon finding one of these flowers, the bee is taking a sip of nectar with its long tongue, while sticky pollen unintentionally attaches to its body. Bee then visits other flowers to gather more food. After the insect received its full meal, it returns to the hive. But how exactly bees utilize electricity to help them find and collect food? Aside from its purpose in communication between bees, scientists have proven that the role of static electricity in the life of a single bee is both to attract pollen grains and distinguish the nectar-rich flowers from those whose nectar resources were recently emptied by another forager bee. Bee's body is positively charged, while flowers tend to have a negative charge, at least on clear days. We know from physics that positive and negative charges attract, while the charges of the same sign repel each other. But how bees build that positive static charge in the first place? A bee, just like other insects, is protected by an outer shell called exoskeleton or cuticle. Besides providing protection, the insect's waxy cuticles are also great insulators. They are so electrically resistant that a substantial charge can build up and stay there. After taking off from the hive on its way to the flowers, a bee flies through the air and collides with charged particles, from dust to small molecules. These impacts tear electrons away from the outer side of the cuticle and the bee ends up with a positive charge. When the positively charged bee arrives at the negatively charged flower, sparks don't fly, but pollen does. So, pollen grains jump to a bee even before it lands on a flower. After the bee takes off with collected food, the flower remains slightly positively charged for a short period, thus warning the next bee of another bee already feeding there recently, which means it currently lacks food. This modified electric field is the signal for other bees to avoid that flower until it resupplies itself. While flying through the air, bee produces a voltage of up to 450 volts. As a comparison, domestic wall socket voltage ranges from 100 to 240 volts only, while electric eel sends 600 volts in an average attack. Collected nectar and pollen are, after bees' foraging activities, taken back to the hive, where other working bees further use them to make honey, propolis, royal jelly, and other bee products that will be stored for later use.